Will this be the song that Eminem disses the game on? DJ Khaled, use that gospel. Kanye West, let's go. How to take gold farm? We back in the building, your DJ back in the seat today. Let's get into this. This has actually been highly anticipated. The new DJ Khaled album is out on all streaming services now. God did. A lot of people have been waiting on this one because I think a lot of people have been wondering if is Eminem going to do what he did on the 5 Joe song where he went at Nick Cannon and just did a little something on the verse? Is he going to do the same thing? I know that's going to be the thought in people's mind when it comes to listening to this song, but I'm really just here for the song first and foremost because I'm thinking that because of the title of this album and the title of this song, Ye on this song, Ye gonna do some gospel shit. This is right in Kanye's wheelhouse. So Eminem on this, they've done songs together. We know that. The Forever song with Lil Wayne, Drake. We've known Kanye West and Eminem to work together before, but this is very interesting. I'm intrigued at this, so no long talking, no delay. Run it. I feel like this is gonna be really heavily gospel infused. Ooh, that beat drop. I feel like this is gonna be like almost close to Christian rap. This is gonna feel like could be a reach on the shelf. Pause. First and foremost, the first thing I noticed, Khaled didn't do his opening intro. He didn't do
another one.
DJ Khaled somewhere in the background on the ad lib. That's really kind of odd on a DJ Khaled album, and that means Ye take over the complete production of this song. That's just how I already seen it. I already hear the layout. He didn't take over this whole song. Because Khaled, we know Khaled could drop his sound effect. Let's go, Ye. We buckle in for this. I like the feel of the song already, just the way it's going.
Use this gospel for protection.
Yeah.
It's a hard road to heaven.
Facts.
We call on your blessings and the Father, we put our faith.
It is a hard, it's a straight road to heaven. It's a lane. We all are on it, but what makes the road really hard is the temptation, the pull, the demons, the darkness. The negative, the people, the negativity that just kind of like tries to pull you off that, you know, highway going to heaven. Let's go.
Kingdom, the kingdom, our demons are trembling. Holy angels defending. And the Father, we put our faith.
I'm holding on, but yeah. I don't know if I can take it much longer. Today's the day that I put all.
Already, Eminem? Y'all give Eminem all this time just to rap? Please tell me y'all ain't gonna let Eminem rap the whole rest of the whole song. OMG. Fuck a rock.
I'm holding on, but yeah. I don't know if I can take it much longer. Today's the day that I put all of my trust and faith in you, Father.
Facts.
Please let this hate make me stronger, for they turn on me like a zombie. It's like I'm being strangled, unconscious.
Yeah.
When temptation is almost like
see, that's, you just said what I've been talking about. It's the temptation with his pull you. Bro, Eminem has been going through controversy through his whole career. I don't think there's nobody in the rap industry who's probably as tough. When I talk about tough skin, tough nails, tough fortitude, tough mentality to go against, like, controversy, to go against backlash, to go against gossip, to go against all the negative shit that comes with. There's nobody. Eminem is, he isn't a sometime talked about person. He isn't a once in a while talked about person. Eminem has been toting controversy and catching hate through his entire career from debut to now. I don't think there's much in the game who was tough as Eminem. Anyone talk but have that mental fortitude to block out shit, boy.
Today's the day that I put all of my trust and faith in you, Father. Please let this hate make me stronger, for they turn on me like a zombie. It's like I'm being strangled, unconscious.
They turn on me like a zombie, get bite, then they turn, change.
When temptation is almost like Satan is baiting you, trying to take you away from your daughters, dangling a bunch of painkillers on your way, venom in your face, and them Watsons coming extra straight, and that's why they make them in rectangular objects, cause that's the shape of a coffin. Though it ain't medication, it's time, but the devil's ain't.
Whoo! That's a slick little pun there. Hold on, let me go back. Say the medication, when it comes extra strength, that's why it come in a square box, like a coffin. but it ain't the medication with killing you. I wonder if that's a little slick one, because you know Eminem is clever with the wordplay.
When temptation is almost like Satan is bitten, you trying to take you
whoop. That whole Satan bit me bit, like I say, is what turns you into a zombie when you get bite, and then you know you transform. Yeah.
From your daughter's dangling a bunch of painkillers on your way, venom in your face, and then what?
Taking you away from your daughter, you know, when you're being on the road as an artist, you always miss time with family. Come on, Eminem, talk.
Trying to take you away from your daughter's dangling a bunch of painkillers on your way, venom in your face, and then Watson's coming extra strict, and that's why they make them in rectangular objects, because that's the shape of a coffin.
Rectangular objects, it's the shape of a coffin. I wonder if that's a little slick pun.
Though it ain't medication, it's time, but the devil's taking me on it. I ain't gonna let him break me, cause I'm a soldier. You can bank on that promise. Like,
you keep egging me on, but like a soldier, I'm not gonna break. If I'm not mistaken, isn't eggs and soldier, I mean, well, we know the egg break scenario, but I'm wondering if that's a breakfast terminology in Europe or something somewhere in British. I don't know, cause that Eminem is very clever when it comes to structuring certain sentences and rhymes, cause they might be missing a little something with that, I think. But, let me know, it could be a reach on the shelf, though.
The devil's taking me on it, I ain't gonna let him break me, cause I'm a soldier, you can bank on that promise. Taking me on it, I ain't gonna let him break me, cause I'm a soldier, you can bank on that promise. Like the Chamber of Commerce, so my savior.
You could bank on that promise, that I'm a soldier, like the Chamber of Commerce. Boy, if you don't know what the Chamber of Commerce is, I ain't gotta explain that.
Cause I'm a soldier, you can bank on that promise. Like the Chamber of Commerce, so my savior, I call on to rescue me from these depths of despair. So these demons better step like a stair, because he is my shepherd, I'm armed with you.
These demons better step like a stair, because Jesus is my shepherd. Like the line Eminem, it ain't complicated. Stairs, better get to stepping like a stair. You gotta take steps on a stair. But just the whole, yes, Christian rap. Eminem doing Christian rap in 2022. What is going on here? What the? I don't want to curse. And he ain't cussing this whole song. And that's highly unlike Eminem. Y'all know Eminem is cuss. All right? For him to go through this whole song so far. Let's keep it going, though.
Me from these depths of despair. So these demons better step like a stair. Because he is my shepherd. I'm armed with Jesus. My weapon is prayer. Soon as I squeeze it, I'm blessed like sneezes. Call me Jesus. I'm effed in the head. Maybe I'm bonkers.
That's the stupidest gun bar for 2022. You heard it here first. That's the craziest gun bar for 2022. Armed with Jesus, prayer is my ammunition. When I squeeze it, I'll bless you like sneezes. It's a crazy gun bar, Eminem. It's fucking crazy, bro. Huh? I didn't want it to come out, but it flew out. I know we on a gospel track. I'm trying to be respectful, you see what I'm saying? I'm trying to stop using the N-word and stop saying the F-word. Let's go, Eminem. But this song is crazy.
Prayer, soon as I squeeze it, I'm blessed like sneezes. Call me Jesus. I'm effed in the head. Maybe I'm bonkers regardless. Never claimed to be flawless.
I'm effed in the head. He didn't even, he could have said I'm up in the head, but he said effed in the head just to cut it short because he didn't want to curse. Come on.
Sneezes, call me Jesus. I'm effed in the head. Maybe I'm bonkers regardless. Never claimed to be flawless. Long list of mistakes I've acknowledged. I wish I would say something.
Anytime Eminem has made a mistake or said something about somebody that someone didn't like or someone took the wrong way, he is always, he just did it with Rihanna. He has done it with many of artists. Always paid homage, always corrected his mistakes. Whenever he said something and he didn't mean, or somebody took it the wrong way, and he had to apologize. Eminem has always acknowledged his mistakes and tried to make up for it and apologize for it. Fox on Fox on Fox.
Bonkers regardless, never claimed to be flawless. Long list of mistakes I've acknowledged. Y'all wish I would say something positive. Well, okay, then I'm positive. They'd rather trade with it with Mayweather.
Y'all want me to say something positive? Okay, I'm positive. Like, clever, simple. You ain't got to think about that too much. I'm not negative. I'm not this way or that way. I'm positive. Y'all want me to say something positive? Okay, I'm a positive guy. Not a pessimist. I'm an optimist. Come on, Eminem. Talk.
But y'all wish I would say something positive. Well, okay, then I'm positive. They'd rather trade with it with Mayweather, because they would fare way better with the mods than they would exchanging some bars or trading any bars with shady. And it probably is painfully obvious to compare godliness to an atheist, but I got them audiences raving and
damn!
You just got your answer.
Woo! There it is! Boom! There goes the dynamite! That's it right there, game. You would fare better with them odds than to exchange bars with Shady. Don't get in the ring with me, game. You can't exchange bars with me. You ain't on my level, people. Someone asked me the other day, say, what do I mean about when I say The Game is not in Eminem's lane. I have never said in none of my videos, you will go back and check, I've never said The Game is a trash rapper. I hold The Game in high regards. I loved his first album. In my personal list, I consider the documentary a classic. Not in everybody else's music overall list. No. My personal list, I still consider the documentary a classic. I was a fan of The Game. I had Game to be the best opponent to go against Eminem in trade diss tracks out of all of his other opponents that Eminem has ever had. What I mean by lanes is Game is a great bully rapper. He has great street raps. But those are two lanes. That's a two-lane road. Eminem has arena anthems. He has thought-provoking tracks. He has storytelling tracks. He has a wider lane. He has more lanes that his music fits into and he raps about. So think about a two-lane roadway versus a 10-lane highway, okay? That's just all I'm saying. And right here, perfect example. He took trade exchange already. That's a double right there. Trade and exchange is the same word. But trade, you know how weather people say, oh, the weather is going to be fair and mild tonight with a slight chance of or a slight odds of rain and thunder. Eminem just kill you with a not only a Christian rap song, but a weatherman announcement. And Game.
And I'm positive they'd rather trade with it with Mayweather, cause they would fare way better with the mods than they would exchanging. Some bars are trading, any bars with shady, and it probably is painfully obvious to compare godliness to an atheist, but I got the...
It's painfully obvious. I compare to godliness to an atheist. I am the rap god. You know what an atheist is? It's just a person who doesn't believe in a higher power, who doesn't believe in Christ. I am godliness in this hip-hop industry. You are just an atheist. That is a bar, Eminem. That is a petty bar. Huh? That literally, on par, reminded me of the eunuch bar that he dropped on Nick. And he was like, I cut my balls off before I lost to eunuch. That's a... Eminem dissing you on a Christian, on a gospel song, using a method of Christian rap. Game, you should feel so sad right about now. I'm pretty sure when The Game hears this, if he even caught it, he's going to be like, I would feel... You did a 10-minute diss track. You didn't say shit. Let's keep it real. That was more than trash. That was the juice that in the bottom of the garbage where the truck is leave behind. It's still stinking in front of your yard. You know when the garbage truck is, take the garbage, but all that juice in the bottom, it still stink. It's still there. You could still... That's what your Black Slim Shady song was. I'm sorry. You did everything. Why your Drillmatic album is flopping. Everything that you did to have these results, you did to yourself, to be real. You did it to yourself, bro. This dude ain't do nothing to you. But he had six bars. Murder your bomba clot.
Audience is raging in the midst of my squabbles. I got some awesome inspiration to drop them off on pen and paper.
Even in the midst of the squabble, I still got some inspiration to drop on y'all.
I'm knocking them off, woke up on stage at a concert, whole place to go like a mosh pit Bible at my side, like a rifle with a God-given gift every single day. I thank God for that's why I pay so much homage, praises to Jesus. I'll always
use this gospel for protection. It's a hard...
That's why I pray to God so much and I pay so much homage. Because he knows what he's doing is special and it's nothing that, you know, he cannot be grateful for. And he have to thank the people who did what he did before him and the people who are still around him in this present time that give him the props that he deserves, bro. Because the nigga has put in work for it, bro. I mean, it is what it is. Hate Eminem, don't listen to him, whatever the case may be, but you gotta respect. That's just what it is.
Use
this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven.
Facts.
We call on your blessings. And the Father, we put our faith. King of the kingdom. Our demons are trembling. Holy angels defending. And the Father, we put our faith.
Better put your faith in him. Ooh, oh yeah, this is a Ye production.
Feeling like I'm walking on water.
Damn, son. Truly needed. I needed this today. I ain't gonna tell you no lie. I needed this. Use this gospel. We've seen Kanye West and Eminem on tracks before, but not like this, though. It's a totally different vibe right here. It's a good feeling. And personally, me, H-O friggin' T. I like this. This is hot. Eminem, way to still be you. Way to still be you and still be petty and throw that little right in there at the game. Game? Sit small to your name call, bro. Don't even think of responding back. Don't even think of dropping a reaction to what you thought about the song or whatever the case may be. Just leave it alone, game. You done sink. Your ship's sinking. Do not respond back. And now you end up with an anchor to pull you down faster. It ain't gonna be good for you. Maybe Eminem might be even trying to throw you an alley-oop just to save your shit. Because who knows? This might be an alley-oop to say, you know what, game? I can save you, bro. Because right now, Eminem actually mentioning you could help you, to be real, to be honest. Because trust me, bro, you going down fast and a hungry man meal on a Sunday. You going down fast. But anyway, on to the next video. I got to get to more songs in the DJ Khaled. But let me know what y'all want me to check out next. I'm actually personally very interested. I'm going to check out that Rick, the Boss, the Fireman, Jigga, and Rick Ross on a track together again. Check this out. In the meantime, between time, peace, health, and wealth. Stay favored, tenuous, be grateful. Love yourself, because ain't nobody else gonna love you like you. Sad, but true. Peace out.